Hi everyone. In the COVID-19 era, we are in a here and now situation. Planning for the future seems to have gone out of the window until we have a cure or a vaccine in place. In times of uncertainty and as we adjust to the new normal, this is our attempt to give you insights into what the leaders in banking and financial services industry are thinking. This is a three-part series, and in each part, we are trying to address the industry challenges and what the future could hold for the sector.
COVID has made companies across industry to rethink how they use the newly acquired knowledge of remote working. While plans of returning to office differ, directness and serendipity of in-person interaction has been key to innovation. Also, social bonding, creativity, brainstorming, etc. are softer aspects of workplace culture. New types of technology will develop that will enable remote working to be more productive, as well as move video conferencing from being transactional to replicating many of the features of in-person interaction. The net effect of all of this is that it will encourage greater diversity in workforce, more general equality, leading to more women leaders in the banking space.
I think clearly future is here for us. In terms of people, I think COVID has presented a big opportunity, especially as in a sense we've experimented with large work from home mandate. Also looked at how functions which weren't configured for remote working responded, and pretty much the operations were uninterrupted, which is where I think what we are looking at is a hybrid model where we will be looking at mandating large work from home agenda even in the new normal, which is possibly three to four months away. The other thing that we are reshaping, at least as we look at not only the workplace, how the work is configured, and the physical manifestation of work. I think in one of the things that has set up is the distributed model of leadership, that everybody is equally accountable. So there's no centralized control center or command center within the risk frameworks that we have. And I think third is learning. Learning is going to be a critical agenda to lead this change. Especially as learning becomes virtual, people are learning a lot more, trying to also reskill them for the new workplace, new reality, new consumers, and new consumer behavior, and how you know, it the organizations which kind of put all these three levers together will definitely have an edge.
The post-COVID-19 situation has several implications for professionals like us. The search for efficiency post-COVID-19 is going to mean that every single role will be questioned for its productivity and for its relevance. And I think all of us have to be prepared for that level of scrutiny. So the first thing that is going to happen is that there are certain roles which will become redundant. For example, in areas where, let's say, video KYC becomes the norm, I think the physical sales channels that sectors like us have employed, which are in large numbers, will reduce in size. And therefore, some of these jobs, relatively in numbers or in their very nature, will become redundant. And these redundancies mean that all of us as professionals, if we happen to be in roles which are likely to be redundant, should have the open-mindedness to retrain ourselves, reskill ourselves to take on other jobs within the bank or within the industry or even outside the industry. So I think consciousness of redundancy of your own roles, one. Two, if you are in that position, open-mindedness to retrain, reskill yourself to take on other roles will become very, very important. And therefore, that I think is the biggest people-related change that COVID-19 is going to bring about.
The new normal, which we, you know, is loosely used, is actually going to be the normal. That is the way the future of work is going to look at in the new people strategy. We will continue to look at people hiring for critical roles with different kinds of skill set. Second, we will see people working, almost 75% of the workforce working from home, with enough and more technology and other ways of compensation to make sure that people are self-sufficient in the new normal. Thirdly, we will see employment becoming a part-time employment, flexible working hours, people working in shifts, and other ways of actually retaining your livelihood, because these are choices employees will make over life and livelihood. Fourth, employees who have been engaged in essential services will have to find out new ways of catering to their customers by servicing them through social distancing and also using enough and more of digital. And therefore, upskilling, knowledge base, as well as upskilling the roles that they play with the support of technology as an enabler, will be the new future of work.
What happens to our hiring strategy or people strategy on a post-pandemic basis? I think the first clear winner in the people side during the pandemic has been the people who've been adaptive, and second, people who have been self-driven. I think being digitized and learning a lot more digital methods is a very obvious one in people. But I must say that most people, doesn't matter age or gender, they're very good on digital already. The other interesting one is we have seen, and I think we will probably see a bit more localized hiring, purely because people have to grow states or have families back home, do present a different kind of a challenge in terms of how things are adjusted. So I think those would be the changes in the people side. Fair to say that the demands of people to be crisis ready have gone up. But having said that, I must say that people have done a brilliant job, both for customers and for the bank during the crisis.
Companies are rethinking their people strategy given cost focus, higher adoption of technological solutions, and social distancing, which is here to stay for some time. Companies are taking a fresh look at the organization structure and span of control across levels to figure out what will work the best in this paradigm. To bring about cost elasticity, companies are reworking the compensation structures to have a much higher variable component versus the 15 to 20 cent norm currently. Companies have also realized the importance of outsourcing in variabilization of the costs. So all processes are being reevaluated with a fresh lens to figure out the right outsourcing candidates. This will mean lower on-roll employee additions going forward. So this crisis is reshaping the entire people strategy of the companies.
On the people front, the focus is really on ensuring that the company has a deep management bench so that the CEO can rely on effective deputies to manage the crisis. The boards are also getting strengthened because the effectiveness of boards is a vital parameter in ensuring the resilience of the underlying business. Certain roles are becoming far more strategic. For example, the role of a CFO becomes particularly critical at a time like this. The role of the CTO becomes very important as technology becomes pervasive. Lastly, but the most important aspect would be to ensure a culture of nimbleness and agility within the organization. And this can be achieved through a combination of employee training as well as leadership coaching.